Good afternoon, YouTube. I wanted to take a quick moment to discuss the whole home dehumidifier that I just completed the install on. It's an Ultra-Aire 98-pint system, and I've connected it to a Nest thermostat to allow it to control the humidity. Now, some of you might be thinking, well, I should probably use a separate thermostat or a separate humidistat to control the humidity in the home. Well, if you have a Nest, you've already spent probably $200 for this device and can easily integrate it to trigger the dehumidifier to come on or off as required. So on the Nest, if you select it twice here, it's kind of set kind of low, but if you look here, it'll actually read out, I can zoom the camera a little bit, a temperature and a humidity level. So that there is showing 52% humidity. And with a couple minor settings in the professional mode, you could actually adjust and set it to that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull this Nest off the wall just for a second so you can see the terminal that I really care about is the star terminal. So that brown wire is not used. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 wires. So around the black tape is a black and a white colored wire. So that's 2, 3 is yellow, 4 is orange, 5 is green, 6 is red, 7 is blue, and 8 is the star brown wire. So the C wire is called the common wire in this system, and that's gonna be important. I'll show you here in a second when we go down to the crawl space. But the star wire, or the brown wire, is just an extra wire that goes from the thermostat here down to the air handling unit. And then what we'll do is we'll use that brown wire at the air handling unit and pull that to the dehumidifier, and that will send a 24-volt signal to trigger the dehumidifier to come on and off. So in the Nest professional mode setup, you can adjust what that star does as an alternate configuration. So it's kind of weird here. You gotta get the Nest lined up, get the circuit board connected. Damage it. There we go. And so it's set up there. There we go. So that's that. So now we're going to jump down to the basement or the crawl space in this unit and shoot the rest of the video. So here's the entrance to the crawl space. Outside we have just a normal compressor. This is an electric heat pump style setup. So you have electric backup heat, and then you have this compressor to provide air conditioning, and it also is used to remove heat from the building, or correction, remove cold from the building or add heat to the air in the winter time. So heat pump style, think a heat pump. And over here you see the condensate drain outside. So we just stubbed out a 1-inch piece of PVC instead of taking it to the septic system, which really wasn't needed. So 1-inch PVC stubbed out, and then a 90-degree turn down to exhaust the condensate. Now you could integrate it into the leach field or the drain field around the house for the gutter system, but we decided not to do that. Okay, so coming down into the crawl space, you see the old air handling unit. And you see a big 10-inch duct. You kind of come around here, show you the survey of the land here. So here we have an Ultra-Aire dehumidifier installed. I was gonna take a video of the install, but it was a little bit cramped, honestly, down here, and didn't wanna get going too crazy with that. I wanted to focus on the install. Took about a day, maybe, yeah, probably less than that, half a day. A couple trips to get supplies, made sure I had all that stuff ahead of time. So with this dehumidifier, it's got a 6-inch port, which is the black line here, which takes fresh air from the outside. It's kind of hard to see there, but goes back. So if I could focus this a little bit better, maybe not. Fresh air from the outside. And then this 10-inch duct here takes a suction from the return, cold air return side on the air handling unit. So what I did here was just modify, this was a 6-inch opening, I modified that to be 10-inch opening. and then ran a 10-inch line for that, and then ran the cold air, the external air supply that actually went to this, to the dehumidifier so that we get dehumidified fresh air into the house. So one nice feature about this Ultra-Aire system is that it's got a filter access panel on both sides. So this access panel is on the other side, same access panel. You can open it up and filter slides out. One not so nice thing about the Ultra-Aire is that the filter size is kind of proprietary. So you're going to find yourself looking for a 14 by 17.5 by 1.75 inch filter. It's a MERV 13, which is pretty high rating. So you got to keep that in mind. So you have the condensate drain here, and then it goes to a condensate pump, and then the thin line kind of goes up and over, and I'll show you the other side there where that discharges to. And then power supply for the condensate pump, power supply for the Ultra-Aire dehumidifier coming to a receptacle that's pretty close proximity to everything else here. And then the condensate pump for the air handler for the air conditioning side is there. So inside here, this is the panel that we took off, and we found that extra brown wire just curled up doing nothing. So we ran a wire from here inside over to the Ultra-Aire. And then on the Ultra-Aire, you have a couple different connections here. So this was tough to find. There's nothing online and nothing in the books that is really gonna show you how to wire this up. So this is a critical point here. The Dehumidifier is the trigger to turn the unit on. And then the common terminal, which you can see here is blue wire, is the basically your supply and return. So the 24 volt signal comes to the dehum section, triggers the unit to come on, and then the blue goes back, that wire gets routed back to the air handler, and the air handler has a blue group of blue wires inside there and a common called the common terminal. So you just connect the two blue wires basically to this brown wire, gets wire nutted inside there, and then comes over to the dehumidifier, and then that connects to the star terminal on the Nest thermostat. So with that being said, when you do your Nest thermostat setup, it will prompt you to say, hey, with the star terminal, what do you have connected to that? And then you say that you have an external dehumidifier selected, and it will automatically trigger the fan on the air handler to come on in parallel with the dehumidifier running, which is critical. So for those of you that I don't have a diagram to show you, but basically the suction of this dehumidifier comes from the cold air return from the house through the 10-inch line, through the dehumidifier with its own fan, and the dehumidifier gets pumped out the 10-inch line and then to the supply registers of the home. Now, what you can't see here, but I promise you is installed, is a backdraft damper, which is right here. So what that allows is air to go that direction with a motive force from the dehumidifier, but no air from the air handler to get pushed back to the dehumidifier. So air handler, air fan supplies the registers. Dehumidifier, air fan supplies the registers with dehumidified air, but the main air handler won't send air back to the dehumidifier with that backdraft damper. So one thing I didn't install, which is why the fan on the air handler has to run in parallel with the dehumidifier, is another baffle damper. So basically saying, hey, if we're dehumidifying the air, I want to stop the flow of air to the air handler so that there wouldn't be any air that runs through this section. I didn't do that, and I don't think it really would have been cost beneficial. I think it's better to run the air handler fan at the same time. And the Nest thermostat knows this and easily allows you to integrate that. So one thing you might wanna consider is this just has a standard 1-inch 20 by 20 filter. If you're gonna be pushing this amount of air through a home, you might consider upgrading your filter assembly to a filter box style. I chose not to do that in this scenario. This is gonna be a house that I'm gonna put on the market here shortly. But I wanted to basically just get something that allows us to control the air quality in the home. A whole house dehumidifier is critical to controlling air quality, especially in the Pacific Northwest. So one thing you do want to remember is that you're going to need to be replacing your filters a little bit more frequently, because you got the fan running, moving air through the home much more than you might normally have just in an area where, you know, you just have the heat running when it's needed or the air conditioning running when it's needed. Now this scenario, you're gonna have the dehumidifier running more frequently to maintain the humidity level in the home. In the summertime, you're gonna run the AC much less, the dehumidifier will run a little bit more. It's cheaper to run the dehumidifier than it is to run the AC unit. One other thing, so I don't know if I could turn the light on here, maybe. Actually, that's not too bad. So these here are ratchet cables to lift the dehumidifier up. I was able to put this in unit in myself. It's about 100 pounds or so. Got it slid through this relatively small opening. It just fit in. And then got it on the mounting brackets and ratcheted it up into place. So if you can see back here, this is just some extra Tygon tubing. But here is a 1-inch PVC comes up. I don't know if I can get a good shot there. But it's not trapped in any way. It's just a line to direct condensate outside. And then the Tygon tubing from the condensate pumps. Now the condensate pumps themselves, prior to the condensate going into them, there is a trap. And that's just something you either bend some PVC yourself with a heat gun or you buy it. I think I bought this one pre-bent. And that allows you to have a little water stoppage there, but it's an inline trap. So pretty straightforward. But all in all, a quick install, Ultra-Aire dehumidifier, highly recommended. They come with a 6-year warranty. They're made in America. And I would definitely install this unit in my own home. The problem is, I've got a pretty good sized place and I'd have to put three of these in because I'd have three different zones. So this particular unit cost about $1,700 and maybe about $150, $200 worth of parts to get it installed. So about $2,000 plus about a day's worth of my work to install it. And again, you do not need to go out and buy a humidistat if you have a Nest thermostat. Let's recap here. So we talked about how we integrated this dehumidifier with the Nest thermostat. We talked about how we did not need to go buy a new thermostat or a humidistat. And we talked about how great the Ultra-Aire air handler is and how good of a warranty it is and made in America, that sort of thing. And the pretty simple wiring diagram. So star terminal, brown wire to air handler, brown wire, pigtail, new brown wire to the dehumidifier. Blue common wire from the dehumidifier back to the air handler, and then nothing needs to change in the thermostat wiring other than adding the brown wire to the star terminal, and then reprogramming your Nest thermostat to tell it that you have a dehumidifier installed, and it'll automatically trigger the air handler fan to turn on when the dehumidifier is running. So I hope this helped some folks that are getting ready to install an Ultra-Aire system. This doesn't only work with Ultra-Aire. Any dehumidifier that is a 24-volt triggering system will work with a Nest thermostat. So keep that in mind. If you don't want to spend the money on the Ultra-Aire and you want to get something cheaper, you can do that. But it has to have a 24-volt triggering system. So keep that in mind with your plans and preparation. And as always, if you like this type of content, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel because we'll try to post more content as it becomes available. I appreciate it and we'll talk to you later.